Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. Now, at this point, we have all heard of Dogbolt.org, the compiler explorer. It's used in virtually every single episode that I record for this channel. But have you heard of Dogbolt, the decompiler explorer? This episode is sponsored by Undo. Do you spend far too much time debugging? Did you know you can cut your debugging time by 50 to 80% with a technique called time travel debugging? Undo offers a full time travel debugging solution for C++ applications. Visit undo.io to see how it works. Undo provides a free trial at the link below for you to play with the tech and explore some of the features of time travel debugging. You can get started in 2 minutes and save yourself days on diagnosing the root cause of complex bugs like race conditions, seg faults, memory corruption, Stack Overflow errors, and more. Now, first of all, there's a lot going on here, and so I'm not going to be able to zoom the UI a whole lot, so I do suggest that you watch this on a slightly larger screen if you can. And also, this has been on my radar to record an episode about it for a very long time, and I just never really got around to it. So it seems that I'm hitting Dogbolt at about the time that they're got like too much load going on right now. I don't know if they need to like clear their work queue or something, but we're gonna give this a try and we're gonna see what we can figure out. I kind of wish that I was doing this as a live stream so that I could ask you for your input for what kind of project you wanna see decompiled. Now it says that it must be less than 2 megabytes. Which is not very big. I might have an idea. Okay, after far too much effort, I got a build of my ConsExpr CLI scripting engine that is small enough that this should work for the sake of putting it in Dogbolt. Okay, so it has uploaded it and it is automatically piping it through Anger, Binary Ninja, Gaidra, and Hexrays. Now, Binary Ninja is an interesting tool for sure. I've played with it briefly and you could check that out. Gaidra is the open source one from the NSA, I believe. And then there's all these other Rec Studio, Reco, Realize, Ret. Dex, no man. I don't know what they are, but let's see if this gives us back some output in the next couple of minutes or so. All right, everyone, the first results are in from Hexrays. Now, we can't resize these windows, and if I try to zoom, I can't scroll them. So this is going to be just a little bit of looking at small words, or perhaps let's see if we can. All right, so we have something here from the decompiler. Now, this is going to be a little interesting to look at because I had a lot of ConsExpr code in this project. So we can try looking at main. So in main, I create my expression evaluator. And it is ConsExpr. Well, its initialization happens at compile time. And then I just pass it a string for evaluation. So I'm assuming that all of these things have to do with setting up the runtime itself for the script engine. No? This seems to actually be the execution of the script inlined in here. So let's see where argc is referenced. No, argv. V5. So it constructs a string view here on line 474. Ah, yeah, okay. See, check this out. We can see it actually mem copying in all of the objects that were in the ConsExpr initialized thing. All right, so then it creates a string view from argv, that makes sense, and then calls parse, calls sequence, checks to see if there's a bad variant access. I need to write code that eliminates the possibility of it even checking for that. Okay, this definitely seems to have done something, and then we can see the destructor called for the engine. All right, that's the destructor, right, which has to destroy a vector if it exists. That's another thing I need to do to change here. So even though I compiled without debug symbols, there's clearly a lot of code that was maintained in here, just in the mangled names of the functions. And it seems to have done a pretty darn good job of demangling those names. Okay, so we haven't gotten any other output yet. Hexrays was the one that came in for us first. Well, that was interesting. I clicked on realize and that managed to generate something basically instantaneously. And we can see the similar kinds of things happening in the main here. Let's see if we see that mem copy of the const expert data, basic string view being set up as well. And the parse sequence destructor, etc. So I feel like we could fairly well trace through this code as well with this other program. Oh, interesting. Oh, it seems that it was running all of these regardless of whether or not they were selected. DWolf doesn't like us. Rec Studio's not done. Recco. Ret data. Snowman's not done. Let's try Recco. Something feels, So this one didn't do demangling of our C++ symbols. And you can see the absolute ridiculously long symbol names that get generated with this highly templatized code. So that one is definitely less useful. And then it looks like ret data is the only one remaining that has generated output that we could test. And this one also did not demangle the symbol names, which makes it considerably more difficult to look at. Let's turn off that one. I'm going to go back to hexrays real quick. It's interesting to see chunks of data that have been memcopied in. Yeah, like this. So you can actually see the different symbols that exist in the engine by default. And then you can see it like, basically, yeah, I think this is correct. Yeah, okay. So V76, V77. Now V77 is clearly a function pointer. It is a function pointer that takes a D word pointer, an N64 and an N64 and an unsigned int. Now, what does it do? I don't know, but it's clearly copying all of the function pointers and chunks of data that make up the state of the scripting engine itself. Again, all these things calculated at compile time since all const expert, copying them all into main. Now, it helps that I already had some idea what this is all going to look like because it's a program that I wrote and then compiled. So V31, let's see, V31 gets assigned this binary boolean apply pairwise less than. So this is the less than function that is a templated function that's being instantiated again at compile time to create this function pointer that it then sets up on the stack. Yeah, that's definitely what's happening. So I don't know. This is fascinating. Again, you know, free service. So I'm not going to complain at all, but it does seem to be a little overwhelmed at the moment. But if decompilation is something that you're interested in, go ahead and check out the Dogbolt Decompiler Explorer. Throw some files in here or check out one of the examples that they can give you. And then you can see for yourself what kind of things these decompilers can do and perhaps, I don't know, consider which one you might be interested in investing in yourself, if that's something you're interested in. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. You know what to do. Be sure to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up.